Well, good morning, everyone. There are more of you out there. Good morning, everyone. Happy Sabbath. It's great to be in God's house today, and I'm so glad to see you all here on this beautiful Sabbath day. It's an exciting time as well, because we have a different program for today, but we do want to cover some of our announcements. We want to remind you about, first of all, about prayer meeting. This coming Wednesday, we will not have prayer meeting, but the following week we will. So just be mindful, prayer meeting will not be this particular week due to, the season and all. Also, too, we want to remind you as well, there is a 21-day fast coming up. I'm probably not going through the slides the right way, beginning on January the 2nd. And we want to encourage you to participate and to choose the way you want to fast, but in offering to God, offering yourself to God. And the pastor wants you to contact him, all those who are going to participate. Now, I was just thinking about it. Some might want to participate, but may be a little afraid because they might fear they might not be able to do it. But please do contact. We want to encourage one another in that wise. Also, too, we want to remind you about the devotional books for the upcoming year. Please get with me or one of the elders to let us know if you'd like one for this upcoming year. We just want you to have a guideline to kind of follow along. Be mindful, too, that their TA is also having a can drive. They're trying to do with their part to feed people in this community. So participate in that wise. It's a great day in God's house, and it's a good time for us to be reminded of so many various things that are happening. Also, too, we just ended a series. The pastor just ended a series, and just note that when we began, I forget the title. He has a new series, and he's excited about it, wanting to present it to us today. You look so good. I'm going to pause right now and say that I want to give everybody a hug. So is everybody ready for a hug? All right, here it comes. All right, here it is. Everybody get your hug? All right. You know, we're in this pandemic, and we just think about there are so many different things that we're challenged with. I know about 6 or 7 people who have COVID-19, and so it's a challenge to us. And so we want to pray on that wise as well, pray for those, their recovery. Some are in dire straits as well. Also, too, I was just looking today in the Bible, the joy of the Lord is our strength. And in Nehemiah 8:10, it says, eat the fat and drink sweet wine. Send portions to anyone who has nothing ready, for this day is holy to our Lord. And do not be grieved, for the joy of the Lord is our strength. We are Christians, and we believe in Jesus and his power to be able to save, and to also to educate and teach us how we're to go from day to day. Before we have a prayer, we have a presentation we'd like to present at this time. The silence is always deafening to me. Can we just sing this chorus? What a fellowship, what a joy divine, you know that? What a fellowship, what a joy divine, Leaning on the everlasting arm, what a blessedness, what a peace is mine. Leaning on the everlasting, Lord, we're leaning, leaning, safe and secure from all alarm. Leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting arm. Amen. All right, just mindful too that while we have a little time, we want to just announce to the church that we have a new member of our church. Should I say a new Vargas? Did we have the baby yet? Oh, I thought we had the baby. Grandma's a little confused. The baby has arrived, born last night. Praise God, mom and child are doing fine. We're so, praise God, we're so thankful for that. It's always an exciting time when babies come into the world. It reminds us of Christmas, when Jesus came into the world, amen? Man was at a very difficult time in this world's history, and God decided to send his son into the world. Reminds me of the scripture that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish but have everlasting life. Amen? And I like the next verse. It says, God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved. Amen. What a joy that is when we think that God so loved us to send his only son into the world. I'm trying to think of another song that comes to my mind that we could sing a cappella. I had a few of them before I got up. Anyone have a favorite? Just maybe a chorus. Amazing Grace. All right. Amazing Grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I am found. Was blind, but now I see. I'm not sure of the second verse, so we're going to hold up there. Beg pardon? Okay. You have one? What is it? Okay, she said Silent Night. All right, here we go. Silent night, holy night, all is calm, all is bright, round yon virgin mother and child, holy infant so tender and mild. Sleep in heavenly peace, sleep in heavenly peace. Amen. You know, and now I'm also thinking about Pastor Smith. He always repeated the Bible text. They overcame by the blood of the Lamb and the word of their testimony. Well, I do have a testimony I'd like to share with you. You know, we had snow last week here in Oklahoma, about 5 or 6 inches, and maybe more in some places. And very exciting to get that much snow. Anyway, I got a call from my mom, who lives about 3 miles away, and she said she had no power. Then I got a call from my neighbor who lived just below the hill. He said he had no power. And we still had power. Amen? Praise God, we still had power. And that's kind of odd because living in Oklahoma, we do things by, it's to the north of us or to the south of us. And these people were all, one was to the north of us and one was to the east of us. So about on Wednesday, we saw a neighbor who lived to the south of us. And they said to us, we lost power too. So that means that the only ones who had power was our family, which lived on the hill. So I just praise God that God is the source of our strength, and he gives us power to endure. One more thing. I see Lorelei in our midst. Hello, Lorelei. Welcome back. We're so glad to see you. We don't have the presentation we want to give to you at this time, but so we'll have our prayer at this time. May the Lord bless us as we come together. Father in heaven, in the name of Jesus, we're so thankful that we have this wonderful privilege of coming into your house of worship. Come near to us, and we pray that you will touch hearts. We praise your name for your goodness to us. You have been so kind to us. 1,000 will fall at your side, and on your right hand, the promise is that it will not come nigh thee. Keep us, Lord, for we cannot keep ourselves. Save us eternally, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. We will continue our worship. So we'd ask that you pray at this time. We're having technical difficulties, as you can turn. We haven't had this ever that I know of. So we're having problems with the screen, and we're just we needed to get trying to get the words up and that sort of thing. That's what's going on. So we'd ask that you pray that the Lord will intervene and that it will come through sooner rather than later. But it's really good to see all of you here in God's house, and I'm sure that God has blessed you because you look as though you have been blessed. I'm just looking. Do we have another song? Let's see if we can find another song. Ooh, wait a minute. What page is that? Oh, I have one. It was suggested power in the blood, but I'm trying to find those words in my phone. Just sing a verse of the old time favorite, "Pass me not, O gentle Savior." All right, I think we all know that one. I'm not sure about the power in the blood. Anyway. Pass me not, O gentle Savior, hear my humble cry. While on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. Savior, oh Savior, hear my humble cry. While on others thou art calling, do not pass me by. Though the spring of all my comfort, more than life for me, heal my wounded, broken spirit. Help my unbelief. Oh, hear us, Savior, oh, Savior. Hear my humble cry. because thou art calling. Do not pass me by. It's taking a little more time to reboot, so we're going to start with our songs. They're pretty familiar songs, and we're going to have hymns that we're going to sing from. So we're going to continue in that wise. Pastor Elder Carrico was saying, you know, I have the app on my phone, the hymnal, so we'll give you the number, and maybe you can look at it on your app if you have it in your phone. Okay. And 132 is the first song that we're going to sing. Stand with us.
Please stand and join us as we sing.
Joyful and a triumphant, come ye, oh, come ye to Bethlehem. Come and behold him, join the King of adore him, oh come let us adore him, Christ the Lord. First to second verse. Sing choirs of angels,
sing of us you.
Sing, all ye citizens of heaven above. Glory to God, glory in the highest.
O come, let us adore him. O come, let us adore.
Number 120, there's a song in the air.
There's a song in the air. There's a star in the sky.
There's a mother's deep prayer. And the baby's low cry. And the stars rains its fire while the beautiful sing for the manger of Bethlehem cradles the King. Fourth verse. There rejoice in the light. And we echo the song that comes down through the night from the heavenly throne. Now we shout to the lovely evangel they sing, and we greet in his cradle our Savior and King. Okay, Silent Night, 143, the first and fourth stanza.
Realize that we don't have any. Just where are you? This is number 18. It may be just a little too much. We were just going to each week this month that we were having the church budget, the finance committee wanted to just give you an update on where we stand. And it is in your bulletin. Organized here. It's on the next to the last page. It says December local church budget report. And last month, the reason we're doing this is because last month we didn't really meet our church budget, and we just wanted to keep people posted as to where we stand. Last week we had a pretty good offering. The week before, of course, was the first week of the month. And we've gotten online donations. We've had a total so far of $4,125 for our church budget. And we didn't put that in here, but the actual budgeted amount is $9,700. So we still need, for December, this is the bottom line, $5,525. And I know that this is a hard time of year for people in their giving, and this is a hard time of year in terms of jobs and all of those things, but if you have it within your power to support our church budget, we just really urge you to do this. We need to meet our obligations, and it's sort of like at home. If I was laid off and wasn't getting any check at all, that's the situation we find ourselves in if we don't meet our church budget giving every month. So that is what our offering is for today. We have collection boxes in the back. After church is over, you can leave your offerings in a tithe envelope, or you can go online from home and give your offerings there. So let's bow our heads for just a moment of prayer about our blessings, our giving, and our church budget. Our Father in heaven, we are grateful that you have given us wonderful gifts. You've given us our lives. You've given us our jobs, our homes, and all of these things really belong to you. We're stewards of your property here on earth, and we just pray today that your Holy Spirit will guide us as we consider our giving for the end of the year to conclude this calendar year 2020 to get our church budget caught up and in the black. And we just thank you for your loving kindness. We pray these things in Jesus' name.
Good morning. If you look in your bulletin, it says James is supposed to be doing the prayer. Obviously, I'm not James. But I just wanted to talk a little bit about prayer. As you know, or maybe most of you know, is we just had an addition to our church family through the Vargas family. Little Addison was born last night at 23:23 is what I was told, I think, 10:23 or 11:23. And just to testify to the power of prayer is every single one of her children, she has prayed for a certain day that they would be born. And that child has come on every single day that they have prayed for. So just never neglect the power of prayer. So at this time, we're going to do our morning prayer. Usually, well, not usually. We haven't done it in a long time. We come down, but we'll just kneel as far as we can where we're at. If you can't kneel, that's fine. Just most importantly, bow the heart, because that is what Jesus wants more importantly. Bowing physically is just a show, but if we're not bowing our heart, then it means nothing. So let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we are thankful, Lord, that we still live in a country that we're able to gather and to worship in your name. Lord, that we still have religious liberty to go out and proselytize to our friends and our family. I just pray, Lord, that you would give us encouragement. This year has kind of beaten us up and torn us down, but I pray that going into 2021 that we would bounce back, that we would remember our calling as a high calling to go and teach and make disciples of the whole world. And also, Lord, we have a lot of people in our church that, not in our church, but members who have family that are suffering with COVID-19. I just pray that you would anoint your healing power upon them, that you would pull them through this. And Lord, there's even other various ailments. There's flu, there's the common cold that are afflicting people. I pray for them as well. I also pray for those that may be dealing with, you know, cancer or diabetes, other things. I just pray, Lord, that you would pour out your spirit upon them. And Lord, as we go forward with our worship service, I just pray that your Holy Spirit would be here anointing us. As we know that our technology is failing us, maybe you are just showing us of a time where we might not have these luxuries. And I just pray, Lord, that it would be our hearts that are in the right place, that we would recognize that we are to worship you in truth and in spirit, and not necessarily depend upon the things of the world to honor and glorify you on this special day. I pray for everyone involved, the singing, the worshipers, or the actors. I pray that you'd help them remember their lines and be with us as we worship you. Amen. In Jesus' name, amen. I think at this time it's gonna start our worship program with Miss Paula Davison. Yep.
Good morning and happy Sabbath. Hello to my church family, those who are here in person, I'm so glad to see you, and those who are online, thank you for joining us this morning. It's my privilege and my honor to invite you as we journey back into the past through songs 2,000 years. These are stories that we are familiar with, but I believe hidden in these stories are lessons. Lessons that God has for you and for me. So sit back and relax and pray. Pray that God opens our hearts to receiving the lessons that He intends for us to learn.
thanks in lonely exile here until the Son of God appear. Rejoice, Emmanuel, shall come to thee, O Israel. O come, thou wisdom from on high, and order all things for.
How can this be, that I am the one who's about to give birth to the Son of God? It doesn't make sense. Hi, I didn't see you there. I don't know if you heard me talking to myself, but my name is Mary. You see, I was chosen to bring the Son of God to this world. He's about to be born now. And though it seems like such a big task, I know with a name like Emmanuel, God with us, that I'm not alone. I was thinking, this isn't a job that I have by myself. This is a job that we all have, to bring Jesus to this world. Did you know, First Tulsa? Did you know that you can bring Jesus to this world? Emmanuel, God with us. We are not alone in our mission.
I cannot believe the day we just had.
We were in our fields watching over our sheep. Yes, I was asleep. But as soon as you started talking about the Messiah to come, I had to stay awake for that conversation.
And then the angel came and told us, the Messiah, the Savior of the world, is here.
We found him in a manger with the animals.
Literally no one had room.
The real question is, do we have room for him here at First Tulsa?
Do we have room for him in our homes?
Do we have room for him in our hearts?
He makes, I love thee, Lord Jesus. look down from the sky and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. Be near me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever and love me. I pray, bless all the dear children with thy tender care, and take us to heaven to live with thee
I knew it. I studied the prophecies and knew the promised Messiah was right around the corner. And when I seen that star, I was like, yeah. I remember thinking, I want to bring the best gift I can give. And the first thing I thought of was my most valuable possession, my myrrh. I don't even know how the Messiah is going to be able to use it, but it was the best thing I had in my home. The question I have for First Tulsa is, are you giving your best or giving excuses? What's the most valuable thing in your home? Are you willing to give it to Jesus? Give it now. It's the wisest thing you can do. And trust me, I'm a wise man. We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Born a king on Bethlehem's plain, gold I bring to crown him again, king forever, ceasing never, all to reign. Oh, star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect light. Glorious now, behold him arise, King and God and sacrifice. Alleluia, alleluia, sounds through the earth and skies. Oh, star of wonder, star
star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy perfect
there when he first came and told us the plan of salvation, how he would come to earth and be despised by man, how he would be beaten and eventually killed. It hurt my heart. I couldn't imagine this happening to our commander. Then he was born. The love of God is so rich, so deep, so wide, that he would love a fallen race so much to give his life for them. This is the kind of God I serve. This is the kind of God we serve. He allows me to be in the process of redemption, and he allows you to be in the process of redemption. Can we stop for a second to recognize the goodness of God, his love, his mercy? He is worthy of our praise, worthy of our adoration, and worthy of our service.
The herald angels sing, glory to the newborn King, peace on earth and mercy mild, God and sinners reconciled. Joyful, O ye nations, rise. Christ by highest heaven adored, Christ the everlasting Lord, in the manger born a king, while adoring angels sing.
Glory.
Please stand and join us as we sing Joy to the World.
Amen. All right, let's bow our heads for a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we just want to thank you so much for the opportunity that we had to be able to reflect upon the life of Christ, to be able to see the Son in which you have given to us because you loved us. And Father God, as we leave this place, may we leave with the knowledge that we are loved. And we have an example of love in you giving your Son, and may you help us to do the same. May we be able to give to those around us. May we be filled with your love in such a way that people are impacted and blessed. May you make an impact on every person in this room, member, visitor, family, and friend. From the youngest to the eldest, we thank you in Jesus' precious name. Amen.